Suppose you are given 86,000 rupees which you have to spend within one day. Otherwise, the money will be vanished. So how do you like to spend the money? Number 1, by going to some expensive places and eating and drinking. Or number 2, by investing the money to buy gold so that it will be useful later. Just like that, every day we get 86,000 seconds, which we can spend in two ways. Number 1, by doing meaningless stuff, cheap entertainment, or being lazy all the time. Or number 2, by investing the time for learning something useful, which could be helpful in life. Benjamin Franklin said, "Time is money." So if you want to be rich, then the first thing you need to do is to stop wasting time. Now what does it mean by wasting time? Those moments when we learn nothing and become dull to just pass the time, only those moments are considered as wasted time. So even if you are gossiping around with your friends but you are learning something from that moment, like why people gossip, what is so enjoyable about gossiping, then it will be not considered as time waste. On the other hand, if you are doing some good work, like you are reading some scriptures, but you are just reading for the sake of it, not to understand or to learn anything from it, then it will be considered as time waste, because in no way it will help you to make your life better. We have mainly three main aspects in our life: health, wealth, and happiness. If any work helps to improve any of these three aspects, then spending time on that work is considered as utilizing the time. So in my opinion, the easiest and simple way to stop wasting time is to ask yourself a question before start doing any work, and that is it going to make my life better? If the answer came is no, it will make my life more miserable, then you need to stop doing that work. Now let us see a simple example how we every day waste our time. After waking up in the morning when all the body parts are stiff, then the best thing to do which will make our life better is exercise. But the thing which we actually do is taking our smartphone, which is not good for our health. Only just 5 minutes. Saying that, we sit down and then we don't even know when hours have been passed. Now some may say, but by checking our smartphone we boost our happiness aspect of our life. Really? Or do we boost jealousy, anxiety and worry more? Now we can change this by following 3 simple steps. Step number 1, scheduling. The main reason why we start our day by checking our smartphone is because most of us have no plan for the day. Means most of us don't have any specific goals to accomplish in a day. Everyone has some dream in their life, but not everyone is ready to provide the dedication, the discipline that is required to make the dream come true. This is why not everyone's dream come true. You must have some dreams in your life. It may be to have a figure like your favorite hero or heroine. Then now ask yourself what you need to do daily to make your this dream come true. Maybe you have to exercise 1 hour daily. So fix a time slot in a day for that activity. For example, from 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. In this way, divide your most of the day in different time slots and schedule some activity. As a result, when you will think that you have some free time in your hand, so you will start to scroll down Facebook or chatting on WhatsApp, then you will look at the clock and see it's 8 o'clock, so you will remember that it's not your free time, it's your time for exercise. Step number 2, no excuse. When you will remember that it's your time to exercise, the next thought that will pop up into your head is, "Oh, I am not feeling well today, I will do it tomorrow." At this time, the 2-minute rule will be helpful for you. You have to tell yourself something like this: "Okay, as I am not feeling good today, so I will just do it for 2 minutes today. Because it is in my schedule, I committed it to myself. And if I am not doing it just for 2 minutes today, then for sure I will not do it tomorrow again." This way, by convincing yourself for doing it just for 2 minutes, when you will start, there will be a chance that after 2 minutes you will be on a flow. As a result, automatically you will not be willing to stop after that 2 minutes. The most difficult step in any work is the starting. If you can overcome that, the rest becomes pretty easy. And if by chance after 2 minutes you are still feeling not doing it, then stop. Now some may think, what is the use of doing it for only 2 minutes? Actually, doing it for 2 minutes is much more valuable. At least you kept your promise that you made to yourself. This will boost your confidence a lot. Step number 3, monitor. We feel motivated only when we progress in some work day by day. So you need to progress even a little bit every day. If you are doing 2 push-ups today, then tomorrow you have to do 3. Or if you are doing 2-minute meditation today, tomorrow you have to do it for 2 minutes 15 seconds. Progress can be little, but it has to be. This little progress will create a happiness inside you that will inspire you to keep going. So don't do it being dull just for the sake of doing it. Monitor your daily progress. When we talk about stop wasting time, the most common excuse that is given, I don't have anything to do, what can I do? Whereas the truth is, I don't want to use my brain, so watching movies and scrolling Facebook is better for me. This will result in nothing but making you dull, because our brain is just like a muscle. The more we exercise it, the more efficiently it works. So we have to keep learning something from everything around us. If we can hold a learning attitude all the time, then only earning will also increase. Learning means lots of earning. Earning not in the sense of only money, but also health and happiness. The things that make our life better, we need to practice them more and more, and the things that make our life bitter, we need to avoid them more and more. This is the easy and simplest way to stop wasting time.